whether it is a spiritual activity or worldly activity, as long as you struggle with a purpose, you struggle with a goal, please be very clear, you can never relax. You can never relax. Person who surrenders to the flow of life, he experiences the inner space and the outer space both at a time. He enjoys the outer space and the inner space both at a time. Throughout these 17 chapters, what Krishna said, he is giving the gist. This is material life. This is spiritual life. This is your being. You have the goal here. You have some goal. In material life, you have some goal. In spiritual life, you have some goal. To achieve the material life goal, you are continuously struggling and working. You are somewhere here. To achieve the spiritual life goal, again you are working, intensely doing yoga, pranayama, pratyahara, all spiritual practices. You are somewhere, when you struggle with material life, you are somewhere here. When you struggle with the spiritual life, you are somewhere here. Please understand, as long as you are struggling, either you can struggle in this direction or in this direction. This is your being. This is your being. As long as you struggle for the material life, you will be avoiding the spiritual life and struggling. As long as you struggle for spiritual life, you will be avoiding the material life and you will be struggling. Both are struggles. You choose either material or spiritual, either horizontal or vertical. Krishna says, relax from both. You may think, what is this? What funny instruction he is giving? If I relax from both, I will lose both. Please understand, when you relax from both, you simply fall into your inner consciousness, into your being, into your inner space. And this space, your inner space, when you experience your inner consciousness, suddenly you realize you can explode in all directions. You don't have to choose between horizontal line and vertical line. You can travel in both the lines at a time. Not only that, you can explode in all directions. But the big difficulty is you need to surrender at least to your own being. You don't need to surrender to somebody else. To whom you surrender is not important. Just relax into your being. Just relax into your inner space. Just relax into your consciousness. Just surrender to your own inner space. Stop the struggle in the material world or in the spiritual world. In the material world, mind, the properties are the goal. You have some goal to achieve. So you are struggling towards that goal. Same way in the spiritual world. Please understand, spiritual world also by and by we fix the goal, enlightenment or some goal, and we try to run towards that goal. According to me, the spiritual goal creates more ego than material goal. At least with material goal, you will understand at some point you cannot achieve and it is too tiring. But with the spiritual goal, you don't even understand what you are doing. Both the goals are taking away your being from your being. When you surrender and relax into your being, suddenly you realize you are not mind or body to choose between horizontal or vertical line. Please understand, as long as you believe you are mind, you will be forced to choose between horizontal or vertical line. Mind always chooses. You will be in dilemma. Mind and dilemma are one and the same. One more thing. The moment you come out of dilemma, mind cannot exist. Mind can exist as long as you have dilemmas. As long as you have confusions, mind can exist. Just tell me, have you seen your mind existing even for a single moment without dilemma? Mind never exists without dilemma. It continues to exist in the dilemma, whether this is right or that is right. When you choose, whatever you choose, at some one day you will be thinking or bothering about your choice. Mind exists only with dilemmas. It is dilemma which is the base for your whole mind. As long as you are mind, you will be choosing between material and spiritual world. People who take up material life always feel they are missing spiritual life. People who take up spiritual life always feel they are missing material life. You choose between the two. Here, first time Krishna is giving ultimate technique for quantum spirituality. He is the first quantum scientist in the inner world. He gives a technique for quantum spirituality. He says, relax and surrender. Suddenly, you will experience the intensity of your consciousness. You will understand, you don't have to choose between horizontal line and vertical line. You can explode in all the 360 degrees.